Hello, in this video we will talk about the most important transport protein in our body, the sodium potassium ATPase pump. We will see some basics, the catalytic cycle of transport of sodium and potassium, and the importance of the pump. Let's get started. Sodium potassium pump carries out the active transport of sodium and potassium. As you already know, the sodium concentration is higher outside than inside. Thus, the gradient is from outside to inside. Potassium concentration is higher inside than outside. So for potassium, gradient is from inside to outside. The sodium potassium ATPase pump moves sodium and potassium against their respective gradients. That is, it transports sodium from inside to outside against its electrochemical gradient and potassium from outside to inside. For this active transport, it needs energy. And the source of energy is mentioned in the name itself. It's ATP. Active transport using ATP directly is called primary active transport. Thus, this transporter carries out primary active transport of sodium and potassium. Talking about the structure, it has three sites for sodium binding, two for potassium, and one for ATP. Now let's talk about the catalytic cycle. We will start from a state when an ATP is bound to the pump, the permeation pathway is open to the inside, and all the sites are empty. Now sodium ions bind to the sodium binding site. Then the ATP that is already bound phosphorylates the pump and ADP leaves. This causes conformational changes that close the pathway from inside. Then it opens outside and sodium ions dissociate into the extracellular fluid. Then two potassium ions bind to the potassium binding sites. Then acyl phosphate bond is hydrolyzed and phosphate is released. This leads to the closing of the pump from outside. Then ATP molecule binds that opens the pump on the inside. The potassium ions then dissociate and the pump returns to the initial state. This cycle is repeated for transport of more ions. Thus, during each cycle, three sodium ions are moved out, two potassium ions are moved in, and one ATP is hydrolyzed into ADP and phosphate. Now let's talk about the importance of this activity. First, it establishes electrochemical gradients for sodium and potassium. Active uptake of potassium concentrates potassium inside the cell, and active extrusion of sodium concentrates sodium outside the cell. The gradient of sodium can secondarily be used for active transport of other substances. For example, glucose uptake by sodium glucose cotransporter at epithelial cells of the proximal tubule. Here, glucose concentration is higher inside the cell. So taking glucose in requires energy. This energy comes from downhill movement of sodium, moving the glucose uphill. Thus, sodium gradient established by this pump is used for active transport of other substances. The second role of the pump is the generation of electronegativity inside the cell. See, during each cycle of the pump, it moves 3 sodium out, but takes only 2 potassium in. Thus, during each cycle, there is a net movement of 1 positive charge outside the cell. With repeated cycle, more positive ions move outside. This makes outside of the cell electropositive and inside of the cell electronegative. This electrical potential is very important for generation and transmission of impulses in excitable cells like neurons and muscle cells. Now the final rule. The pump helps maintain cell volume. But how? See, inside the cell, we have proteins and some other large organic molecules that cannot move out of the cell. They carry negative charges. So they attract positive ions like sodium and potassium from outside to inside. The entry of these ions tends to increase osmolarity inside the cell. That would bring the water in and cells swell. If it's left unchecked, the cells continue to swell until they eventually burst. Fortunately, this is prevented by sodium potassium ATPase pump. The proteins do attract ions inside the cell. But as we have seen, the pump takes only 2 ions in and moves 3 ions out of the cell. So there is a net movement of 1 ion out of the cell. This extrusion balances the entry of ions. So the osmolarity is not affected and cell volume is maintained. This was all about the sodium potassium ATPase pump. Let's have a quick summary. Sodium potassium ATPase pump actively transports sodium out of the cell and potassium into the cell. During each cycle, it moves 3 sodium out, 2 potassium in, and uses 1 ATP. The sodium gradient established by this pump can be secondarily used to transport other substances against their electrochemical gradient. By moving 1 net positive ion outside, it creates electronegativity inside the cell. This is required for impulse transmission in neurons and muscles. Finally, it balances the ion entry driven by negatively charged proteins inside the cell, which contributes to maintain cell volume. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.